No, it just seems to be a vendetta against the one family.
Any description?
Well, he's a skinhead, he's about 15 years old, and he's got tattoos. And they think he attends Edward Elgar Comprehensive. Okay, then I'll hold on.
Thanks very much. Much obliged.
What's that?
Houston, I've gone home for the weekend.
How's that?
The Intercity Savings, only £4 more expensive than the ordinary single.
Daft.
You mean you're ringing the railway station?
Yeah.
What do you think that is? Public phone box?
Sorry, sir.
No, there's a customer, Jane Seatall. What's the 708 for?
Need to know.
She's claiming a new skirt.
Oh, yeah. Ripped in the course of duty.
What was his name?
Barbed wire, if you're interested.
I'll get into it right away. Thanks, Jack.
Thanks very much.
Leave him for me.
Governor wants to see you.
Yeah.
What's the good news?
Don't bother to smile.
What's all that about?
Bomb hoaxes. They did the town hall again yesterday. Well, he plays golf with the chief executive, didn't he?
Well, Galloway?
Super, you Wally.
Oh, I see.
Still doing up for your nephew's christening, sir?
Yeah, that's right.
Oh, I didn't know they went in for that sort of thing in a Welsh Orthodox.
They're making you a godfather, are they?
And what not, Marlon Brando? No, of course you know the real reason he's going down there, don't you? Mary Evans.
George.
Yeah, well, it's all the same thing, isn't it? Touch the old OTS.
Oh, look, I've got to find a brick wall to talk to, will you?
It's definitely
nice. Slamming the police station.
No.
Wood Close Primary, that's in Pound Place, isn't it?
Yes.
All right, well, I'll try and get somebody down there as soon as possible, Mr. Davis. All right, bye-bye. Wood Close Primary, that's not on your patches, is it, Yorkie?
No. Oh, come on. We can wait all bloody day. Looks like the staff up at Edward Elgar's playing truant and all. Why do you ask, Taff?
I was the headmaster.
What, Mr. Davis?
Uh-huh.
Oh, I did meet Love Your Local Bobby and Don't Talk to Strangers a couple of months back. He's a nice old buffer. Perhaps he wants an encore.
John, can you pop down to Wood Close Primary for me?
Oh, is this a conspiracy or something?
Intent to deprive you of your skirt.
No, look, there's a kid gone missing. They're worried about her.
I shouldn't think they've even finished prayers yet.
I want an observation on that phone box, right?
An oboe? But so...
It's been going on for a month now.
Yes, sir, but what hoax is going to come back to the same call box unless he's an idiot?
Somebody who finds it amusing to bring the town hall to a standstill probably is an idiot. Besides, the last two phone calls did come from them.
Will that be all, sir?
Yes, thank you, Roy.
What did he want?
Action on the town hall bomb hoaxes.
Ah, yes. I've discovered something quite interesting about that.
What, are the lamb and flag?
No, Toby's wine bar, actually. No, listen, remember that spate of hoaxes about 3 months back? For the local rag, the funeral parlour, there?
Mm-hmm.
Well, they were all to members of the local council.
So what's new?
Who voted in camera against sacking the chief executive.
Come off it, Ted. What, you suggesting a communist plot?
Or ratepayers' revolt?
Well, this could be your big moment.
What do you mean?
Catch the subversive red-handed. Sue wants someone to watch the Surrey Street call box. You better ring through, see if the oboe van's available. And, go easy on the scotch, you might have to see straight.
Thank you for coming so promptly. My name is Davis, by the way. You're
WPC Acton.
I've got the mother in my office. Really very lucky. The child had left a lunchbox at home, otherwise we might have known nothing about it.
Well, she hasn't ever skipped school before.
No, she hasn't. Up this way.
Oh, sorry.
Well, to be quite frank, there are one or two I wouldn't be particularly worried about. We do have our fair share of truancy, even at this age. But Samantha, she isn't that type. Mother's a nice woman.
Well, what about the father?
No, I don't know him so well. He doesn't come to the school very often. He's a West Indian bus driver.
Any other children?
No, no.
Iron rations.
I'm sure you'll manage to survive.
I probably will die of boredom, Carver. Looks like the governor's got it in for you more than usual.
The thought did cross my mind. Actually, the super had him on the carpet. Never grown up, have you, Jimmy?
I never said a word.
Oh. Nothing like travelling incognito, is there?
And I get the impression someone is leaning on him.
Leaning on the sofa?
I don't know. Yeah, take these, will you? Council politics.
Like Watergate.
Yeah.
Comfortable, boys?
Piss off.
She hasn't said anything about bullying, anything of that sort.
No.
I'm sorry to have to ask you this, but has there been anything at home that could have upset her?
How do you mean?
Well, it's just if someone had been cross with her.
No.
Or if there'd been any kind of trouble between you and your husband.
No.
No?
I really think I should be getting back, if you don't mind. I phoned the bus station for my husband to come home and he might have forgotten. And Sammy might...
Yes, of course. Look, I'll pop in later on if that's all right. Pick up a photograph.
Crisp. What flavour am I?
Can't see.
Can't you tell by the taste?
No.
Have a nice day.
Get stuffed.
All units from Sierra Oscar. Missing since 8:30 this morning is an 8-year-old girl. She's half West Indian, the hair tied back, wearing a pale blue anorak, green tartan skirt and white socks, and answers to the name of Samantha Welsh. She's about 3 feet 6 inches tall and was last seen as her home, 75/75, Elizabeth Garrett Anderson block on the Riverdale estate, leaving to go to Woodcross Primary, Pound Place. Sierra Oscar out.
Skyvenor School. This thing's filthy. Flick the wipers, will you?
So, when does our phantom caller normally strike, then?
Between noon and 4:30.
You better go easy on those things. You reckon it could be school kids, then?
Well...
Samantha has tended to be slapdash in her written work this term. Should spend less time dreaming.
Hmm. Any reason for the dreaming?
No, it's nothing evident. And children do go through phases, you know.
I see here it says she has some problems with relationships within the group.
Well, that'll be Miss Horrocks. It probably means that she doesn't talk in class.
Does she seem lonely?
Well, she has struck up this friendship with Teresa this term. It's an odd alliance. Irish family, 1 of 8. Well, you'll see what I mean in a moment. Of course, we have already asked all the children if anyone has seen her today. Yes, come.
Yeah, I'll leave her with you, if I may. It's art.
Thank you, Miss Horrocks. Right. Come and sit down, Teresa. Nothing to be frightened of. Police lady just wants to ask you one or two questions, that's all.
I ain't done nothing.
Oh, I didn't think you had. I just want you to tell me a bit about Samantha. Well, Mr. Davis says that you always go home together.
Yes.
Hmm? When you're on your way home, do you ever go anywhere? Don't go to the playground, park, anywhere like that? Do you have anywhere secret? When you've been with Samantha, has anyone ever come up and talked to you? Offered you sweets? Anything like that?
Do you think there's a possibility that Samantha might have gone off or something?
Well, we have to consider it, that's all. I shouldn't worry, it's 1 in a million. It's just, if you should hear anybody coming about property.
Yes, of course. Now then, she gave you her address.
Yes. Thanks very much.
Thank you.
Cheerio. I've come to pick up the photograph.
Oh, yeah. Do you want to come in a sec? I'll go and get it. Yeah, that was taken from her first term, but we're close. Oh, I've got some more recent. This is the Swiss. Didn't put it out because she wasn't smiling. It's a good likeness.
Do you think I might have a full-length one too? You'll get them back. Yeah. Thanks. Is there a phone nearby that you can use to call us if she turns up here?
There's a phone box in the flats. Would you like a cup of tea?
No, thanks. I ought to get back to the station, write up my report. Yeah, I'm going to be back soon, won't you?
Can you get me beef or tea?
Yep. Mm-hmm. Ah, WPC Acton from Sierra Oscar here. Can you do me a juvenile check, please? The surname is Welsh. Date of birth 5577. And the address 75 Elizabeth Garrett Anderson House.
Yes,
Riverdale Estate, London E1. Yeah, she's gone missing. That's the reason for my
summing
check.
Up. Yeah, June's got a misper. Little girl from Woodclose Primary. Been gone about 2.5 hours.
No trace.
Keep me posted, Tom.
Thanks, Henry. Yeah. Much obliged. Bye.
Tell Muswell to get over to Binney Street, make some inquiries.
Right, Serge. 210 from Sierra Oscar. Are you receiving? Over.
210 to Sierra Oscar, receiving. Go ahead, over.
Read the misper reported earlier. Can you go to Binney Street to make local inquiries?
I need a slash.
She's wearing a blue anorak, green tartan skirt and white socks.
Guess who's coming?
The mystery voice?
Lovely Rita.
It's a London accent, Sierra Oscar, over.
Perhaps we could invite her in.
Share your pork pie.
You ever stop thinking about sex?
Do you ever stop thinking about your stomach?
Oh, funny.
Morning, sir.
Good morning.
Just making inquiries about a little girl who's gone missing this morning.
She's on her way back. 2 minutes, 50 seconds. Mean cow. Now?
No, no, wait. Now!
Got her!
Yeah, she's supposed to be meeting me at Bangor Station, then driving me on the Glamperis. Mm. She makes it, that is. She's bought herself this old banger. It's having problems overheating. Oh, stuff it.
You've not seen him in school all term. Mind you, you don't seem all that bothered.
What about the juvenile?
First thing I did, Sarge.
Mm. Yeah, but we're supposed to be going down for this meal with her parents.
Oh, what's the serious as that, is it? Now, look, you want to be careful with that, otherwise it's going to be those wedding bills before you know where you are.
Well, they only sail once in a blue.
Ah, yeah, but now you know what they say, don't you?
But what sort of harassment?
Well, turns through the letterbox. The latest thing, slashing their tyres.
Have you had a word with parents?
No, I thought about the education welfare.
No, we'll get around to it. Now, have you had a word with the parents? Because I think the best thing would have a word with the dad.
Is it the morning? Right. Never mind. Here, Albert. Excuse me,
I'll come round. Sarge, there's nobody using the interview room, sir.
No, go ahead.
It's back the way you came.
Straight up.
take a seat.
Sit down.
Right. What seems to be the problem?
I'm afraid Teresa hasn't told you everything. She thought it might be a sin.
Samantha, when you saw this man, but you didn't tell anybody about it. Well, nobody at all. Not even your mum.
No.
Can you tell me what the man looked like? Look, my love, Samantha's your friend, isn't she?
Yes. Mm?
Well, I want you to think very hard, because we want to try and find her, don't we?
Right.
Tom, what's the score on this missing kid? I've just had the local hack onto me.
June's in the interview room now with the headmaster and some kid.
I thought I told you to keep me posted.
What, old and Mr. Davis?
No.
Now, did he say anything to you when you saw him?
Male, about 70. Grey hair, a bit thin on top. Glasses, NHS. About 5'8", I'd say. Short, weatherproof jacket. French poodle.
What?
He's got a French poodle with him. Hasn't got one of those haircuts, though. Yeah, I'd say it's getting on a bit too.
For God's sake.
For God's sake, what? Identification would be a bloody sight easier if all villains were dog owners. You know what I think? I think
Sierra Oscar 6, Sierra Oscar 6 from Sierra Oscar, receiving, over.
Receiving, Taffy, over.
Return to the station with your vehicle and contact D.I. Galloway as soon as possible. Sierra Oscar, over.
Thanks, Taffy. Out.
Hear that? We're being released.
We're having to treat this MISPA as an abduction, which means you're all going to have to stay on this afternoon and assist in the inquiries. Bob, I'd like you and Martella to do house-to-house inquiries in the flats. Alice and Carver, I want you to search the grounds. All sheds, basements, boiler rooms, dumps, etc. Littleton and Muswell, I want you to search the timber yard, which is adjacent to the block of flats. Ackland, I want you to liaise with the parents, find out if this kid mentioned anything about a flasher.
Well, don't you think Mrs. Walsh would have told me?
It's still necessary to put him in the picture.
Where have we got?
Here.
She'll turn up. We'll be on that night train, don't worry.
Don't have many night trains these days.
It starts. It's all right with time anyway.
You and Jimmy, you take the other panda, all right? Viv and me were going to the bus.
Taking a leak.
This missing kid could be serious.
Did he strike?
A friend, Gov. What?
This elusive hoaxer. We did see this bloke with a poodle.
Mike. Look, shut up.
We're looking for a flasher. So I want you to check out any sex offenders in the area that match up with that description. All right?
Okay.
You call this a description?
It's a kid. She was frightened at the time, anyway.
There's a dump round the back. We'll start there.
House to house, they call it. Wonder if the lifts work.
Better add.
Well, enough of stairs for one day.
Don't be like that.
Well, of the five possibles, three are inside.
I've got to go anyway. Work. Look, I'll ring you as soon as I can. Okay. Bye.
Trouble? Well, there we are. Only two. One rape of juvenile and one indecencies.
Well, I suppose we'd better go and find them.
Yep.
It's just really to keep you in the picture.
Oh, yes, of course.
May I come in?
Oh, yes, sorry.
Is your husband back yet?
Yeah, he's in the lounge. Please go through.
Ah, Mr. Welsh. I'm WPC Acklin.
I see you have a search party.
Did you smoke?
No, thanks. I hope you don't mind. I need to have a bit more of a chat about Samantha.
Terence Lowe, 1 Bell Walk, 37 years old, raped a 12-year-old girl. Life. Released 26th of the 4th. Some bloody shrink, I think.
We're just checking up on him, Mike, that's all.
It's a bit upmarket. What's he do for a living?
He's only been out a month. Oh, very green him, don't you think?
Yeah.
I think he's gone away somewhere.
Any idea where?
He didn't say.
Touching up a bit, are we?
I like to keep things looking nice.
Looks great from here. Do you know when he went?
Yesterday or today, I'm not sure. He asked me to cancel the milk.
Oh, nice to have a caring neighbour.
Mike, put her down.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
And she hasn't mentioned any worries, anything that could have upset her. Mr. Davis did say that her work had slipped a bit recently. Do you have any idea why?
That's that Teresa. You know, I'll try to keep her away, but you can't. You know, not when they're in school anyhow. And she even gave him mitts.
What about her other school friends? Does she ever go anywhere with them?
Oh, no, she always comes straight home.
Mr. Welsh, what about places she might have been to with you?
Well, we don't go to a lot of places. No, not really. Damon takes her out once in a while. And on the buses and the swimming baths. Oh, we went to Panto, Stratford, last Christmas. Yeah, we all three went.
Do you go anywhere particular on the buses?
Usual places.
Or like?
Zoo.
Yeah.
Museums. Kalisar.
Yeah, but it wasn't recent.
I know you're both naturally very anxious. And I don't want you to jump to conclusions. But we are having to consider every kind of possibility, however slight.
Yes, but would you bother to cancel the milk?
I haven't got a milkman.
Aye. Better put out a bulletin for him anyway.
Well, keep your mind on the job, you horny bastard. Sorry, mate. And you watch the bloody road.
Where's the next one?
Right.
Sierra Oscar 5 to Sierra Oscar. Receiving over.
Clear, Mike. Over.
Will you get the collator to put out a bulletin for the whereabouts of Terence Lowe?
Has Samantha ever mentioned a man to you?
What kind of man?
We've had a statement from one of the children.
that a man exposed himself to her and Samantha. Now, it could well be unconnected, but we are having to consider all the possibilities.
You keep saying that.
I'm sorry.
They're in the rubbish dump now.
Please don't.
Why? That's where they're looking.
It's normal procedure.
For you, maybe.
Well, if it is Hammond, she'll be in luck.
Why?
Because he wouldn't hurt a fly.
Oh, no, just gets little girls.
I said hurt. Anyway, he's been out nearly 2 years.
Well, what's that supposed to prove?
It's the one with the flowers.
Well, how?
I nicked him.
You've been giving him a council place.
He lives with his mother.
How nice.
Mrs. Hammond.
Yes?
Detective Sergeant Roach from Sunhill Police Station. This is Detective Constable Dashwood.
What's he done?
Well, most likely nothing. Could we just have a word with him? Is he in?
No, he's out. He's at work. He's got a job.
Ah, well, can you tell us where that is, please?
Well, he's only been there a few weeks.
Don't worry, madam. We won't cause him any trouble.
It's the cab garage in St. Olaf's.
Thank you very much, madam. Just one more thing. Can you tell me what time he left for work this morning?
8:15.
What time did he get here, then?
9:15. What's he done then? Robbed a bank? Anyway, you'll find him in there.
Cheers, mate.
Right on, mate.
Derek in? Derek?
Do you mind if I have a look in our room before I go?
Normal procedure?
Yes. Yes, as a matter of fact. Please, Mr. Welsh, I promise you, abduction is only one of the possibilities.
Abduction?
It's just as likely she's taken herself off somewhere.
Can't you leave us alone?
Damon.
Shut up.
I'm sorry. I do understand.
It's the next room.
It's a very tough time for you.
The bedroom.
Oh, top.
Benjamin Bunny.
What happened to his ear? Mr. McGregor get him?
She chooses. I'm sorry if I...
Oh, it's all right, no problem.
My wife is always apologizing for me.
Is that a cut yourself?
It's meant to be St. Catherine's dock, last year. I promised to take her again, but...
What about the picture of you and her? When was that taken?
Margate.
Last summer? Did your wife take it?
No. A photographer on the front. My wife was in hospital. You know, women's things.
But she's okay now?
Yes. Perfectly all right.
It's nothing to do with me. Just because I've got a previous. I haven't touched a kid since I've been out.
Mike, I think we need a cup of tea.
What?
Get us a cup of tea. Sugar? One with, one without. Listen, my friend, we are not trying to nail you. We are trying to eliminate you from our inquiries. For your sake as well as ours. Listen, with a thing like this and your record, people are bound to point the finger. Eh? Now, all I want to know is what you were doing between 8:15 and 9:15 this morning, then you're free to go.
You're not going to keep me here.
I don't want to have to.
Thank you, Mr. Gage. And of course, we'll be in touch as soon as we have any news.
Okay, thank you.
Goodbye.
Well, it looks as though June Ashton's been doing her stuff. Have you contacted Margie?
Yes, sir. I've also sent a couple of officers down to St. Catherine's dock. Most of the rest was covered anyway.
What's the score on Terence Lowe?
Nothing apart from the neighbour. She says it's the first time he's been away. Apart from the last 6 years, of course. We've put out a bulletin to all local stations.
Well, get him on the national computer. What about this fellow they've got downstairs?
Roach is talking to him now.
Press?
Press Bureau's got a complete update.
Local radio, TV?
Not yet.
Well, get on to that, will you? Have you contacted the DSC or SPG units?
No, sir.
Right, I'll do that now. Chief Superintendent Brownlee? Oh, hello, George. What is it this time? Oh, no, not again. Look, George, we are doing our best. I'm sorry, what? Look, George, I'm rather up to my eyes in things at the moment, all right?
Another town hall bomb hoax, sir?
No, not the town hall this time. Turkish baths. Seems they caught the leader of the council in the middle of his thirsty afternoon steam. Hello, could I have the controller, SPG, please?
My father was here last year. Talk about clutching at straws. Do you reckon they bring the diving team in?
Sooner or later, yeah.
I reckon leave will be cancelled tomorrow too, if you don't find it.
What if you tell them it's a christening?
No, I wouldn't feel right.
Wasted.
Bloody hell. You've got enough there to feed an army.
All that fresh air.
It's not bleeding Sunday school outing, you know. That kid could be dead.
Good afternoon, sir.
Afternoon. Drink?
No, sir, thank you. Not on duty.
Plenty more. Downstairs.
I'm making inquiries about a child who went missing this morning. Little girl, wearing a blue anorak.
Relation of yours?
I wondered whether you might have seen her.
Who?
This little girl.
Very muzzy. No seabeds. Not as young as I was. Wearing a tartan skirt, wasn't she?
Sorry, sir?
That little girl, you will be. Black watch. Mile regiment. An awful lot of people seem to wear it. These.
Anyone sitting here? That's all right, don't mind me.
I'll have to catch up with you.
Had a hard day, have you?
Yeah, a bit.
Yeah, they got a bloke helping them with inquiries.
Big deal.
How do they take it?
Not the parents. It's awful. They're so screwed up.
Hardly surprising in circumstances.
Maybe. She'd been crying.
They told her?
No. I found a hanky.
Oh, perhaps you should be in a CID. Joel Galloway?
Now,
You remember she was wearing a black watch, tartan skirt, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you saw her this morning?
Isn't it tomorrow yet?
No, not quite. Now, did you see her this morning?
Yes, I keep telling everyone.
Good. Was she with anyone?
Nothing to drink.
Coffee. Here we are.
Now, come on. Get this down, yeah? It'll do you good. There. Now listen. This is very important. This child's life could be in danger.
Can I have a drink?
No! Only coffee. Now, please. You must be able to remember. Was the child on her own? Or was she with somebody?
No, I'm not sure. She was. It was this woman who... spotted coat, like a leopard or something. Have you brought me a drink?
They were seen.
Right.
I want this ground covered thoroughly.
Right, sir.
I'm interested in any piece of clothing, anything at all that will give us a lead, yeah?
Okay, right, sir, thank you. Right.
Get in here,
Roger. Fine.
Well.
Okay.
Good sleep.
About 2 hours. How's our legless friend?
A bit better by the time I let him go. Be careful, Ted. Be here but for the grace of God.
Does he still say he saw the kid with a woman?
Your description as well.
You know, something that strikes me as very odd. Neither of the little girls told their parents or anyone.
Okay. Yes, officer.
It's about a little girl who was in this area about this time yesterday, and we wondered whether you might have seen her.
No, I'm
sorry, sir. Sorry to delay you, sir.
Okay.
Now, why is that, Pete?
A black watch tartan skirt, white socks, and brown sandal-type shoes. If anyone has any information, can they please contact the incident room at Sun Hill Police Station?
Okay. Hello, Sun Hill Incident Room.
Yeah, sunshine.
Hello, Roy.
Yeah, hi.
And no, she's at the Welsh flat.
Yeah, like trainers, is it for the strike?
Yeah, I told her not to be too long.
Yeah, I'm really. Yeah, all right.
Yeah, of course I will. Yeah, I'll tell her as soon as she gets in.
Yeah, I've got that. Thank you very much.
Yeah, bye.
Thanks.
Bexley Heath.
Paddington, either somebody's cloning or she's grown wings.
Oh, glasses!
Yeah, makes you wonder why we bother giving out a description, doesn't it?
Oh, no, police station,
no
room.
Oh, June?
Yeah, that's right.
Galloway wants you to have a word with the O'Brien girl again, all right?
Oh, OK.
Hollywood tea.
Hello, Sun Hill. Pips.
Right,
hello, Sun Hill Incident Room.
How long ago was it that you saw her?
Can you give me your name and telephone number, please?
I could use a cup of tea.
Well,
get it yourself.
I only ask.
Hello, could I speak to Mr. Davis, please?
Could you describe
it for me,
please?
Hello, Mr. Davis. It's WPC Ackland here. I'd like to come in and have another word with Theresa O'Brien, if I may. Ah. Okay, I'll pop round and see her at home then.
Yeah.
Yes, thank you anyway. Of course, we'll keep you in touch. Cheerio. Hey, Teresa's not at school.
Don't say she's been abducted.
It's because of that little girl, isn't it?
Yes.
He wouldn't do a thing like that.
Well, unfortunately, he doesn't have a very satisfactory alibi, Mrs. Hammond.
You said to me you wouldn't cause him any trouble.
Look, if he's done nothing, he'll be all right.
It'll cost him his job.
Oh, hello. Came to see why you weren't at school. Are you on your own?
St. Sergius, Father Donoghue.
Yes. Oh, see if he knows who Joe Bryan's family, will you?
I doubt if he knows anybody these days.
Oh, is he a bit classic?
Too much sacramental Irish, I think. Still, I'll have a word.
Yeah, do.
Yeah. How was your girl about last night?
Nah, not too bad, all things considered. Particularly since she was waiting for me 2 hours at Banjo Station. And a Mars casserole would all drag. No, it's my sister who gave me over there. It's weird that, isn't it? I mean, you'd think her being a married woman and all that.
Okay, how
are
we doing
here? Yeah, right. Sending police into the room.
Airport 53, Lewis were ringing us back. Caused some trouble with West Indians, just they have too many kids.
How'd you get on?
Lean useless. Apart from Peter, thinking he's spotted a Nick Wogbox.
Right, we'll leave those with us and grab yourself a cup of tea. Let's check your actions, all right? Hello, Sun Hill Incident Room.
What have we got now? We warm 2 46s and a 47.
Yes, I'll be with you in a tick. Roy, I've got Brighton on the line. They've picked up low.
Yeah,
right.
Okay.
Hello. Yeah, can you hold on to him and I'll get someone down there straight away?
Why were you scared to go to school? Did you tell a fib?
She didn't admit it, but I'm positive it was a lie. It was written all over her face.
Great.
Have Roach and Dashwood left for Brighton yet?
Yeah. Why, is there something wrong?
Just that our little friend from Wood Close has been leading us up the garden path, that's all.
What do you mean?
The flasher we've been chasing after never existed.
What'd you do that?
It's the least of our worries at the moment, isn't it?
What, do you think I should call Roach and Dashwood back?
Do you have to?
Hmm?
Open the bloody window.
I thought you were allergic to fresh air.
I like clean lungs.
And a lousy liver.
Oh, come on, leave it out.
There's our phone box.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, what time is it?
12:05.
Did you see anybody?
Come on, get your shoes back on. She's got another 2 actions up there, yeah?
And how would you say she was looking?
Anyway, bet that kid's probably making sandcastles on Margate Beach now.
Oh, did you say she seemed upset at all?
Anyway, all kids like a little weep.
Can you describe the woman in this? A leopard skin Mac. Yes, we'll send someone over right away. Are you ringing from the shop? Thank you very much indeed.
Kids time?
Well, maybe that old gypsy wasn't seeing things after all.
Come on, Ackland. I'll buy you a teddy bear.
You sure it's her?
I think so, and I remember the blue anorak.
Did she buy anything else?
Just a colouring book and some felt tips.
And the kid was all right?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Well, I don't know, did I? I didn't take much notice. Look, you don't when you're serving a customer. You just serve them and they...
All right, it's all right.
She looked happy enough. Well, nothing like a few presents, is there?
How does she pay?
Credit card.
Hello, Roy. Can you spell that? L-U.
Here, yeah, it looks as though you might be able to chalk up a couple of tired nights after all, doesn't it?
Sure, I mean, Mum's put you up.
Look, take her to the best hotel. You've earned your overtime, haven't you?
It's probably just another red herring.
Oh, I don't know so much.
Yeah. Well, I'll ring you back as soon as they come up with it. Looks like we're on to her. Lubacheska.
Is she local?
Sounds like out of space to me.
You guys lodge?
Oh, good name. Can I get an
answer there?
Yeah, I'm on the way.
Well, we've had dealings with a woman of that name. She lives in Pickford Crescent. She married a Polish bloke who got killed in a hit and run about a year ago. I was the mug that had to tell her.
Good afternoon. This is Sergeant Cryer of Sunhill Police Station, Metropolitan Police. We're trying to locate the owner of a credit card.
She wouldn't have bought a colouring book if anything had happened to her, surely?
I'm sure it's her. Here, Pickford Crescent.
What is it you want, number 5?
Yeah, that's it.
All right. Lubacheska?
Yes.
And Detective Inspector Galloway? I'm making inquiries into the disappearance of a little girl called Samantha Walsh. We have reason to believe...
Please, sir! We're only having a tea party.
Samantha? We've come to take you home.
Look, George, I'm very sorry, but you really must appreciate I've had to divert all my available manpower for this missing child.
Yes, I'm sorry now.
Sorry? Very well, George, if that's how you feel. I wish somebody would bloody well blow him up. Right, where the hell have you two been?
Halfway to Brighton, sir.
Summer holiday?
No, we went to interview Terence Lowe.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Hey, it's great about the kid, isn't it, sir?
Yes.
Eh? Well, nothing's gone wrong, has it, sir?
The chief executive intends reporting us to the Complaints Bureau.
What? Another bloody hoax?
Yes.
They won't half be pleased to see you.
Well, everything's all right, my friend. We're letting you go.
You were widowed last year.
Yes.
Any kids of your own? What made you pick her?
I thought she was lost.
On her way to school?
No, she wasn't going to school.
How could you tell where she was going?
She was by the boats. She was watching the boats.
That was the first time you saw her?
At the docks. I like the docks. Especially in the summer. There are people to talk to. Families.
Whatever.
What are you here for, you stupid bitch?
You should
believe
me, Sergeant, thank you.
What are you...